Hello everyone, today we will be seeing the 25th chapter of Charaka Chikitsasthana, which is called as Dvivraniya Adhyaya. So in this chapter we will be seeing what are the types of vrana, how the treatment of vrana need to be done. Even though this is a Shalya Adhikrita chapter, means it is Adhikara or Shalya Tantra, but still there is some shamana which can be done over here. So Acharya Charaka has judiciously incorporated this chapter in this Chikitsasthana. So let's see what are the introduction to this chapter. The term vrana literally means destruction or rupture or discontinuation of the body tissues. This chapter gives comprehensive information about endogenous and exogenous ulcers or agantuja and nijavrana. So that is why it is called as dvivraniya. There are two types of vrana. One is agantuja vrana and one is nijavrana. Trivida pariksha or three different way of examination of ulcer is done by darshana, Prashna and Sparshana. We will discuss what is that. Where inspection or darshana is been especially done on visual examination, deals with general examination and local examination to make proper diagnosis. Etiological factors, nature of pain, satnya satnya, drug, status of digestive power, etc. is done by indogration or prashna. Palpation or sparshana is the mode of direct examination done by palpating the margin, size, depth, temperature, stiffness and hardness of the ulcer. So this is how the three parisha has been done. Prognosis of ulcer is determined by location like tuk, shira, mamsa, medha, asti, snayu, marma, andrashayas, etc. Various complications of ulcer like visarpa, pakshagada, shira, stambha, jwara, etc. are described in this chapter. Slouching of ligaments and vessels, deep-seated appearance of maggots, fractures of bone near the ulcer, presence of foreign body in the ulcer, etc. that hampers the healing process is also explained well detailed in this chapter. Treatment of nija is different from agantuja vrana because endogenous ulcers are caused by the vishesana of vatadi doshas and exogenous ulcers are initially caused by the various types of trauma such as vadha, bhadha, then prapantana, injury due to teeth and nails, etc. So what is the difference between the nija vrana and agantuja vrana? How to initiate the treatment of nija vrana and agantuja vrana is also told. But later on, exogenous ulcer or agantuja vrana also involved doshas take place, and then treatment should be adopted as a nija vrana. The concept of that is also explained. The endogenous ulcer shodhana therapy should be adopted by vamana, virajana, basti and rakta mokshana, and removal of dosha from the body and agnikarma is also explained. So all these concepts are explained in this chapter. Agnikarma has the ushna guna which opposes the vata and kapha. Due to the heat, vasodilation lead to the elevation of srotorodha, resulting in the proper vascularity to the organ or the part. How agnikarma is effective in treating ulcer is been told. Then exogenous ulcer local treatment and use of chara, surgical intervention and cauterization is recommended. All these concepts are detailed explained in this chapter. So let's initially start with the nija vrana. What are the types of nija vrana? So basically we have three types of nija vrana. One is vataja vrana, pittaja vrana and kapha vrana. So these vranas are identified based on the difference in the lakshana of this vrana. So lakshana of vataja vrana is that it has stambha, kathina samsparsha, then manda srava, ati tivra ruk, tudyada, spurana, shava aruna maruta sambhava. So these are the lakshanas that can be seen in vataja vrana. And the treatment what specially we give for this ulcer by shamana aushadhi etc. is that we can do sampurana to the ulcer. Sampurana means filling up of the ulcer. Snehapana to the ulcer it can be done, that is oilation therapy. Entire snehapana can also be done, and snehapana only to the ulcer area or sthanika sneha can also be done. Snigdha Sveda can be done, Upanaha Sveda can be done, which is application of hot paste of drugs. Pradeha can be applied, various ointments. Parishekha or effusion, which are unctuous in nature, can be applied in vataja condition of vrana. Then Paitika vrana will be having the symptoms like Trishna, Moha, Jwara, Sveda, Daha, Dhruti, Avadharana, then Vidhyat, Gandha Nihya Putisrava or exudation of false smelling material that will be exudated. So the treatment for Paitika Vrana is that Pradeha, which is application of hot paste of drug, Parisechana, effusion therapy, सर्पी पाना इंटेक ऑफ मेडिकेटेड घी विरेचना और परगटे थेरेपी कैन बी एडवाइज्ड एंड लास्ट टाइप ऑफ निज अल्सर इज निज व्रणा इज कफज व्रणा वेर द लक्षणस लाइक बहुपिच्छ गुरु स्निग्ध स्तिमित मंद वेदना पांडुवर्ण अल्प संक्लेशन और लेस स्लजिंग और स्लाउजिंग और चिरकारी दैट इज लॉन्ग ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द अल्सर कैन बी सीन इन दीज कंडीशन द ट्रीटमेंट लाइक Pradeha can be given, which is application of hot place. Parisechana can be given, which is sufficient therapy. Especially this is given with Kashaya, Katu, Ruksha, Ushna, Guna, Dravyas. And Langhana and Pachana can also be advised in Kapha Varna. So these will be the treatment aspect and the lakshanas of individual Varnas. Now seeing the characteristics of a Varna, what will be the characteristics? We can see that there are further classified into 20 varieties depending upon the different in their nature. They are examined in three different ways, which is called as Darshana, Sparshana and Prashna. In advanced stage of their manifestation, they exhibit 12 different characteristic features. We'll see what are they. Their locations are 8 in number. We'll see what are the locations of it. They are associated with 8 types of false smell. We will see what are those. There are 14 types of discharge from Vrana. We'll see that. 16 type of complication can also occur. So till this, I will complete in this video. Later things we will see in the later stages. There are 24 factors causing implementation of healing ulcer. There are 36 effective therapeutical methods for treating ulcer. So the first one what we will be discussing about them is the Vrana Bheda, or what are the 20 types of Vrana that is there. So first one among that is that Krita, Kritya, or those required intervention, especially incision, etc. Or the term is also interpreted as curable ulcers. So opposite to that is Akritya, which is saying that those not require surgical intervention. So they are just be healed. This term also interpreted as incurable. There is a interpretation like that, but it is actually whether it is required surgical intervention or non-surgical intervention. That is called as Kritya and Akritya. Next is Dushta and Adushta. Dushta means purified ulcer and Adushta means ulcer which are not purified. Next is Marmastita or ulcer located in the marmas. Then Amarmastita, which are not located in the vital organs. Then next is Samvrita and Vivrita. Samvrita means which is closed ulcer and Vivrita is open or exposed ulcer. Daruna and Adaruna. Daruna means hard ulcer and Adaruna means soft ulcer. Next is Shravani and Ashravani. Shravani means which are ulcer which are profuse discharge, and Ashravani means ulcer with no discharge or scattered discharge is called as Ashravani. Then Savisha and Avisha. Savisha means ulcer which is having poisonous effect and that causes or caused by the poison, and Avisha are those ulcers which are not poisonous and which are not caused by the poison. Vishamastita and Samastita. Vishamastita are the ulcers which are having regular borders and which are located in the uneven parts of the body. And Samastita are which are having regular borders or which are located in the uneven part of the body. So this is uneven part, this is even part of the body. And this is the wrong interpretation. And these are having not regular borders. Okay. Vishamastita is having not regular borders, one O is extra. Then Utsanga and Anutsanga. Utsanga is that ulcer which are having thin borders, and Anutsanga is ulcer which are having thick borders. Okay. Then Utsana and Anutsana is that Utsangi, this is, and it is Utsanna, which is having elevated surface. Means if this is a ulcer, the sides of this ulcer will be elevated, or you can have this kind of presentation. If you view from the side of this ulcer, the walls of the ulcer will be elevated. Anutsana is having depressed surface, means here it will be, this is a normal skin and it will be depressed over here. So this kind of ulcer is called as Anutsana. So these were the 20 types of ulcer. Now seeing the Trivida Parikshas, what are there for ulcer is that Vrana Pariksha is carried out in three different ways, that is Darshana, Sparshana, Prashna and some Sparsha. Darshana means inception. Inspection, Prashna means interrogation, and Samsparsha means palpation. So what all things to be done by Darshana? We have to do the Vaya or age of the patient, Varna, Sharira and Indriya by Darshana. And Prashna need to be done on Hetu, Arthi. Arthi means the nature of the pain, Satmya and Agnibela. These things to be done by Prashna. And Samsparsha need to be done on Mardava, that is stiffness or hardness of the ulcer. Shaitya, coldness or the heat in the ulcer part and other body areas. So this will be the examination what we'll be doing. Now coming to the characteristics of features of ulcer in the advanced stage, we have 12 characters like this. So one is Swetavat, that is paleness in the ulcer. Avasanna, Vartmatva, depression in the margin of the ulcer. Atisthula Vartmatva, excessive thickness in the margin of the ulcer. Atipincharitva, that is excessive red or yellowish coloration, mixed coloration of the ulcer. Neelatva, that is blue coloration of the ulcer. Shavatva, that is black coloration of the ulcer. Atipindikatva, that is appearance of eruption in excess around the ulcer. Then 8th and 9th is Rakta Krishnatva, that is reddish or blackish discoloration of the ulcer. Adiputitva, that is excessive putrefaction of the ulcer. Ropyatva, that is recurrence of the ulcer, or after it heals again it is coming back, that is Ropyatva. Then Kumbhi Mukhatva is the ulcer having narrow opening or the expanded base like a jar, like a kumbha, like this. If it is having not there like this, if it is having narrow base, means it will be having something like this, just like a jar. Its base will be thick and the opening will be small. So this will be a Kumbhi Mukhatva. Okay. Now the sthana or the places where the ulcer can occur is that it is Toga Asraya, where it is located in the skin. Sira Asraya, where it is located in the vessels. Mamsa Asraya, where it is located in the tissue. Medha Asraya, where it is located in the adipose tissue. Asthi Asraya, where it is located in the bone. Snayu Asraya, where it is located in the ligaments. Marma Asraya, where it is located in the vital organs. And Antra Asraya or Postra Asraya, which is located in the visceral organs. So these are the locations of ulcer. There are 8 in number. Okay. Next, coming to the Gandha of ulcer or the different smell or putrefied smell that comes out of ulcer, it is Sarpi Gandha, which is smell of ghee. Taila Gandha, oil. Vasa Gandha, smell of fat. Puya Gandha, smell of pus. Rakta Gandha, smell of red blood. Then Shyava Gandha, which is smell of emitted when the curd is rubbed over the copper. What smell comes, that color. Amla Gandha, which is smell associated with sour substances, that smell. Puti Gandha, which is a putrefied smell. These are the 8 different smells that an ulcer can emit. Now coming into the Srava or the exudation from the ulcer, it can be Lasika Srava, like a fluid or a clear fluid, lymphatic exudation. Jala Srava, like water discharge. Uya Srava, pus discharge. Asrak Srava, blood discharge. Haridra Srava, discharge which is yellow like turmeric. Aruna Srava, discharge which are reddish in color. Pinchara Srava, discharge which is mixed red and yellowish in color. Then Kashaya Srava, discharge like a brown blackish coloration. Neela Srava, bluish color. Haridha Srava, greenish in color. Snigdha Srava, unctuous discharge. Ruksha Srava, which is dry nature. Sita Srava, cold discharge, whitish in color. Asita Srava, which is blackish in color. These are the 14 Sravas that a ulcer can exudate. Next, coming to the Upadrava of ulcer, what are the complications that a ulcer can have? They say that it can have Visarpa, which is erysipelas or a spreading kind of skin disease. Pakshagada, a hemiplegia. Sirastamba, stiffness of the vessels. Apatanaka, convulsions. Moha, unconsciousness. Unmada, insanity. Then Vadana Ruk, acute pain of the ulcer. Vrana Ruk, which is acute pain in the ulcer. Jwara, fever. Trishna. Then Hanugraha, Lokjo. Kasa, Chardi. Atisara, Hikka, Shwasa. And Vepadu. Vepadu means trembling. This will be the Upadravas or complication what an ulcer can cause. Okay. I hope you understood the concepts and I hope the types will be remembered. It is a very important thing. Most of the time it comes for the MCQs and all those things. So please by heart those things. It is better to by heart these things the earliest. So in case of any queries, we'll meet up and discuss in the discussion forums. Thank you very much.